corrupt or the strugglers, the neighbor. We said here that the caravans came from the world or the area of Sham, and the West Winds, they went to capture those caravan. That caravan called Raqd. So we have three groups here. The Muslims group, and the pagans came from Mecca groups, and the travelers is another group. Another group. ولكن أسمع منك ولو سبحان الله and listen carefully to this ولو تواعدتم لاختلفتم في الميعاد يا الله. Even if you want to make an appointment to meet in this area, the Udwa al-Dunya, the Udwa al-Qusra, and the Raqba, the travelers, in that area, in that standard of places, you will not all go to meet in that moment, on that time, on that day, you're not going to meet. Because you don't have this kind of standard like a GPS and a clock and watch and this and that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said clearly, ولكن ليقضي الله أمرا كان مفعولا. Because this is the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By Allah will, everybody meet on that area, on that place, on that time, on that moment. ليقضي الله by the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قضى الله, قضاء الله, this is the destiny, the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people met in that area. This comes with him. You go, ولو توعدتم اختلفوا في ميعاد ولكن ليقضي الله ما قال ليهلك من هلك عن بينة ويحيى من حي عن بينة وإن الله لسميع العليم. Then Allah subhanahu يهلك من هلك. Those people, they choose to die. They choose to die. In fact, why they choose to die? When Abu Sufyan, he sent someone to Mecca to call those people to come and fight. And Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab and the leaders of Quraysh, they came to fight the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The leaders, the big shot of people, those people, they came to fight the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when Abu Sufyan, he want to test those people, because he find out that Abu Sufyan, he went to different direction. Abu Sufyan went to different direction. So he don't need of the people of Quraysh, but he want to test the people of Quraysh. If there is a problem like this happen, can they come and fight or not? Then he found out, yes, they can come. Then he told the people, go back. We don't need you. We went to different direction. The area where is the Red Sea. The Red Sea, they went to the area, the Raqb asfar minkum, Raqb asfar minkum, that means down there where the Red Sea is right now. Say in the area of Jeddah. Then what happened, and then Abu Sufyan, he told the people, go back. Go back, we don't need you. But they insist to come. Say, no, 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 Abu Jahl, he says, no, we have to go over there, we're gonna drink the wine, and we're gonna listen to the music, and we're gonna do all kind of haram things, and let the Arab, all the Arab, the Arabian Peninsula, know that we were there to hear about us, for the Arab to hear about us. So that's why the Ahlak, to be whoever choose to be dead, to be destroyed. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِيَهْلَكَ مَنْ هَلَكَ عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ. Allah showed him the truth. Allah showed him the truth. But they refuse the truth. They don't want the truth. They become blind about the truth. That is arrogant, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. They become so arrogant, they don't want to listen to the truth. They know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the right path. They know that. But because they are arrogant, and not only that, and even the shaitan was with them. Even the shaitan, he carried a flag with them. We're going to listen to this now. This is in some ayat here coming up. said the soil. He killed the flood with them, and he came in the form of Suraq ibn Malik ibn Shaj'a. He came in the form of the man. Everybody knew that man, and he carried a flag, and he came with them. But when he saw Jibril, the Shaytan, he knows Jibril, he went back. And we're gonna go with this ayah right now, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. So that ala bayid wa inna Allah la sami'un alim. Allah hearing the du'a, the invocation of the Muslims, and knows what they want, and they know the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah sami' sami' Allah azza wa jalla sami' that he hear your tadarru' your du'a. And Alim Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and knows what they want, you want, and knows what they want. They want showing off, nothing else. Nothing else. Alright. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in ayah number, so, and also I want to mention something in the ayah before, something, the people of Quraysh, they came 1,000 of them, almost 1,000, and the Muslim, they didn't know how many they are. The Muslim, they didn't know how many, and they saw kids. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he sent Ali ibn Abi Talib and some of the Sahaba رضوان الله تعالى عليهم to find out, you know, how many they are, those people. And they captured two slaves, kids. And they brought these kids, and they hid the kids, and they said, tell us how many they are. And they said, well, you are belong to whom? You are a slave to whom? And they said, we are slaves to Quraysh. And they hid them again. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was praying. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was praying. And then they hid them, tell us, you are slaves to whom? And they said, we are slaves to Quraysh. And then, after they got beating those kids, and they said, no, we are slaves to Abu Sufyan, then they left them, because, and they lie, they are, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he finishes salah, says, subhanallah, when those kids saying the truth, you beat them up. If they lie to you, they, you lift them. They are the slaves of Quraysh. And Prophet ﷺ, he asked the kids nicely, see how many they are, those people. So we don't know how many they are. Of course they are kids. And the Prophet ﷺ, so smart, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, how many camels they slaughters every day? And say, one day they slaughter 9, one day they slaughter 10. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they are around 900 to 1,000. That means every 10 people, they can eat one camel, 10 camel, 1 camel. 10 people, they can eat 1 camel. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he said, tell me who are there. And he says, with those people, فَمِنُوا أَسْرَفْ قُرَيْشِ He says, عُتْبَ ibn رَبِيعَ and شَيْبَ ibn رَبِيعَ and الْبُخْتَرِي and they say, he start to name the great people, Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab, and those people, the great people of Quraysh. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Mecca, they send the leaders, the people, the most stronger people, the most stronger people, Quraysh, they came here to die. To die. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives the glad tidings, the news to the Sahaba, those people, they're gonna die, that's it. And when we go to this ayat, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make miracles in these battles. Great miracles on those battles. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. So, from ayah number 43 to 44, did this take a title? A beautiful title. Say, تقليل الله كل فئة في عين الأخسر. Say, everybody saw the numbers, small numbers. The disbelievers look at the Muslims, they found there are small numbers, and the believers look at, and the disbelievers, they find the small numbers. Look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. إِذْ يُرِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنَامِكَ قَلِيلًا. Remember, I said, I mentioned last week or week before, said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the miracles, made the Sahaba sleep for a moment. one of the miracles to relax, to get some relax. See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in that moment of sleeping some kind of dream. What, almost, what will happen in that battle? Not in detail, not everything. See, وَلَوْ أَرَاكُمُ اللَّهُ كَثِيرٌ لَفَشِلْتُمْ. And some of the Sahaba, they saw the dreams also, but not complete dreams. Not everything gonna happen. Why? Because if the وَلَوْ أَرَاكَهُمُ اللَّهُ, if you see the whole battle, what gonna happen? لَفَشِلْتُمْ. You will just depend that the weaker they will be defeated, and the self, and they will be defeated. Yourself will be defeated because you think they will be defeated by the will of Allah. Then you will depend on that. You're not going to fight. You will be defeated yourself. وَلَتَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ سَلَّمْ. And you will just argue. Some people will fight, some people will not fight. You can have an argument. Then you will defeat it. So it's always the argument. Argument caused defeat between Muslims, between people, between husband and wife, between brother and brother, between sisters and sisters. Between always this kind of argument causing some kind of defeat. Because when you have this argument, you have some kind of hate in the heart, subhanAllah. That's why we said in elections, in kind of elections, when you know, any kind of elections, always come kind of animosity in the heart. I want to be a president and someone else will be a president. The people will hate each other. He want to be a treasure and that person will be a treasure. There can be some kind of animosity in between. SubhanAllah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, Sallam, inna alimun bidat al-sutur. Allah knows what is in the heart of the people. Any kind of dispute among the people will cause some kind of animosity. Allah knows what's going to happen. That's why He show you some of the dream, not the whole dream. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذْ يُرِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ إِذْ إِلْتَقَيْتُمْ فِي أَعْيُنِكُمْ. Now this is the miracle. Now is the miracle. إِذْ إِلْتَقَيْتُمْ فِي أَعْيُنِكُمْ قَلِيلًا وَيُقَلِّلُكُمْ فِي أَعْيُنِهِمْ. Then the Muslims, they look at the pagans, the people of Quraysh, they say they are small in number. And one of the Sahaba says, how many you think they are? Say around 70. And the Sahaba says, no, they are around 100. They are around 100. But the reality is 1,000. And the disbelievers, those also the pagans, they said the same thing. They are small in number. That's why they say, so you think because of your religion you will be victory? But you are very small in number. That I mean less than even 313. That's what their number they see. See? And they are, the both of them, they look at each other, they are a small number. لِيَقْضِيَ اللَّهُ أَمْرًا كَانَ مَفْعُولًا. Because the destiny of Allah, Allah wants both parties to look at each other, to belittle each other. Why? Because the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِلَى اللَّهُ ترجع الأمور. Everything will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything will be go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But here, the ayah number 45 and 46, we're speaking about the manners and etiquettes of war. Bismillah. Alhamdulillah. This is a hadith, beautiful hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تتمنوا لقاء العدو. Do not wish to meet the enemy. That means do not wish to fight. Why this kind of fighting? Both parties will lose people. People will die. وَسْأَلُوا اللَّهَ الْعَافِيَةِ. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the health and the wealth. See, but if there is no choice, then you fight. If there is no choice, then you fight. And the best of here, if they are making scream and noise, you're making dhikr, always remembering Allah and making dua. Remembering Allah and making dua. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is one of the manners and etiquettes of the war, making dua and ask Allah في دعاء ذكر، ذكر في الله سبحانه وتعالى. يا أيها الذين آمنوا، الله calling the believers. How many times in this surah Allah subhanahu calling the believers over and over again and again. See?